Although environmentalists welcome the presidential directive as a crucial step in reversing environmental damage, charcoal dealers are left puzzled and concerned about their future. Eli Senyonjo, the chairperson of the Charcoal Traders Association, reveals that while there are over 500 members in the umbrella body, there are thousands more involved in the charcoal business.
Because when you count the bags of charcoal which is still in forest, there are many. And even those trees which has already cut, it cannot grow again. Eh? And even those charcoal which is still in process, it comes also to make our business to be down totally.
Senyonjo acknowledges that the current lack of affordable alternative energy sources for household needs contributes to the high cost of charcoal, which is expected to worsen for low-income earners.
Now the bag has been at 70,000 K. After this resolution, after this presidential order, I think the bag is going to be cost of 100 plus if someone is going to use charcoal.
Seemingly worried, Senyonjo says the ban on charcoal burning, if not reversed, is likely to push them out of business and most painfully make them lose millions of money they had already injected in.
We have been encouraging people to plant more trees, and even we have been paying taxes. We have been paying taxes through the district forest officers, through the district cows, by paying 1.2 plus to every district from northern region. And that money which we have been paying, they have been cutting some money for planting more trees.
Currently, a sack of charcoal costs between 70 to 100,000 shillings. Due to the absence of affordable alternatives, the cost of charcoal is anticipated to increase further. This will make it even more challenging for low-income earners to afford.
It is already a political issue, which was being caused by those some of the parties like Gilbert Olanya and Odongo Oto, who have entered our business to make it to be political.
According to the directive, President Yoweri Museveni banned tree cutting for commercial charcoal production. Additionally, the president expelled Balalo herdsmen in northern Uganda as part of the same initiative. The executive order issued under Article 992 of the Constitution was released by the president last week.
We want to meet the president so that he can come and help us. Because if he cannot be in that business, what business are we going to do? We are more than 1,000 people who are dealing in that business of charcoal. And even our president, as that is our president, let him also get mass on us.
Mixed reactions arise within the community regarding the ban on charcoal burning. Some support the ban as a necessary step to reverse environmental damage, while others call the ban to be codified into law. MPs are engaging in discussions to address the issue and are considering drafting legislation that would solidify the ban on charcoal burning. This report was compiled by Jaliat Namuaya for the news.